powerful prayers, all the most powerful prayers every Christian needs to know, learning to pray like a powerful prayer warrior. Written by Father Andy Byancol. Narrated by Chanel Sound. The power of prayer. A prayer is a religious act that glorifies God and increases our need for Him. Through living a life of prayer, we respond to the mission of redemption of Christ and connect for our creation with the very root and purpose. The role of prayer in the life of each Christian is directed and answered by some essential questions. Why do we need to pray? Several truths serve to explain why in our lives we need prayer. 1. We have to pray. We read many times that we must be in constant prayer. 1 Thessalonians 5, 16, 18, Philippians 4, 6 to 8, Ephesians 6, 18 to 19. And Jesus in Luke spoke to them a parable that people should always pray and not lose heart. Luke 18:1, NKJV. 2. It brings glory to God. Prayer is God's way of serving. Luke 2:36-38. We have the ability, by prayer, to glorify and thank God for everything He is and has done. 1 Thessalonians 5:18. 3. It helps us to resolve issues. Jesus asks Peter to pray to conquer the desire for help. Matthew 26:41. Jesus also shows the importance of prayer in making significant judgments in Luke 6:12-13. Prayer makes us face all sorts of challenges and conquer them. 4. Prayer takes our need to Him. Ask, and you shall be given. Seek, and you shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you, said Jesus in Matthew 7:7. This does not mean that anything we ask will be granted. But when we ask for things that are in His will, He will give us those things. 1 John 5:14-15. This helps us to understand His will. Jesus started to appeal for help to the Lord. When we remain in communion with Him, we too can begin to understand His will for us. How are we going to pray? Be anxious for nothing, but let your request be made known to God in all things through prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, and the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Philippians 4:6-7. Paul urges us to pray with a heart of gratitude for everything. He will protect us with His peace when we are open and present everything to Him. This passage captures the heart and mind when we pray that we should strive to have. Combined with 1 Thessalonians 5:16-18, we see how we should be in constant prayer. That is, we should always be in contact with our Lord and Savior. What if when we pray, we can find the words right? In our weaknesses, too, the Spirit helps. Romans 8:26-27. As Christians, the Spirit intercedes through worship on our behalf. Many people tend to concentrate on less relevant prayer elements. Care should be taken on details, such as whether or not we shut our doors, what time of day we pray, and how long and how many prayers we say. These kinds of guidelines can be useful or harmful. Get close to God, and He will draw near to you. Prayer should reflect our relationship with God. After all, Thinking that we were given the ability to communicate with Him is beautiful. We may worship Him at any moment and anywhere, pray for His power, discern His will, and become more like God. As James 4:8 says, approach God, and He will draw near you. Ministry leaders in all settings should model the leadership of Christian servants to serve others and point them to Christ. Power of prayers. The power of prayer can help spiritual leaders grow and inspire others to communicate with God. As a Christian, in our own lives, we know the power of prayer as well as its power for the lives of our children. We want so many wishes, aspirations, ambitions, expectations for ourselves and our children. How can we get all these things? The only response is to pray. The Bible is overflowing with the assurances of Christ, and we must use these promises from the words of God as the basis for caring for ourselves and our loved ones. We need to pray in our lives for the reality of those promises. The prayers have immense power over the people or concerns for whom we pray. But we must expect God to work in His way and in His time. If you have to keep praying for years, we have to be careful. So keep praying for years because that's the most powerful thing you can do. One day, there will be miracles. Prayer is our fellowship with our Father, opening our hearts to Him, and expressing our grievances. At His feet, prayer is an open expression of our woes, just as a child speaks to his father or mother. What if we pray earnestly, bargain with Him? What will happen? Consider what happened to Hannah's future. All her pain and fears vanished after she poured out all her mental distress to the Almighty. He reached a spiritual peace that the earth could not offer, and her spirit was filled with God's love that surpasses all comprehension. Her heart and soul are overflowing with joy, though in her womb the child was not yet formed. A little boy named Samuel was born to her because of her prayers to her Heavenly Father. It was a product of her endurance as well. Indeed, the Lord, who always looks at our prayers, will surely listen to and respond to our prayers of supplication. Should you pray daily, thanking God for the food you eat? Would you wish that the car runs appropriately until you drive in your vehicle or inquire for protection from a personal injury? Are you full of love and happiness in your prayers? Or do you pray only when you're sick, lost your job, and faced with grim news? Is the act of prayer to your personal sincere and done privately? Apostle Paul urges us in 1 Thessalonians 5, versicle 17, to pray always. This Bible reference answers the questions above. When you pray, how do you feel? Does the prayer act strengthen the illusion that you already had? Is prayer like having a conversation with God, with a higher power, or with the universe? Must it always be friendly? What if you feel angry, wounded, cheated, and don't know where your worth should be directed? Is this not a good time to pray? Isn't this a great chance to pull all your cards to the table? Yeah, no, perhaps. You could pour your entire heart in prayer and without the restriction of censorship and by the help of the Holy Spirit, it would be approved. How to change the way you pray? These are some interesting questions to discuss. Prayer's influence isn't the way that you attribute to it. It's the sense of being not alone, of being part of and contributing to a larger whole. In times of need and days of victory, prayer embraces you. It will never let you down. Only put it, you can count on it. Larry Dossey, a well-known...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.